Well, welcome back to another exciting weekend of turkey hunting here in Michigan. Today's our opening day. We tried getting up here this morning, or our plan was to come up here this morning, but a couple weeks ago my grandpa gave me a call and asked if we could help him plant 500 white spruce pine trees, I believe, and then a couple apple trees back at his house. So we did that this morning. We got up here about noon, so it only took us a couple hours to plant 500 trees. We had seven of us helping, so that worked out great. We did have an overcast last night and some winds, so we didn't miss much, I don't think. So we are unloading the truck. We're going to get dressed. We're going to head out, see what we can call in, or maybe see if they're just going to come across the fields to come out and feed. So we're going to get that done. So I'm going to get dressed and we're going to head out. buddy. It's the next day here. So we came up Saturday. It's Sunday today. And it got real windy. And then it rained again last night. And it looks like it's going to rain again. We're at 20 mile an hour winds right now. So I got some feeders I want to look at. Not for the turkeys. Corn feeders that we've had sitting around since we've been in banned in Michigan for baiting, so all the corn feeders we've had in the previous years, I don't know how long it's been since we've been allowed to bait up here. So they just been sitting in the back room while I've been on other YouTubers' channels and seeing that they were doing pond feeders and stuff like that. And I'm like, well, we feed our fish, but maybe once every month or every other month. So I was like, well, we got all these corn feeders sitting around. I'll just fill those up. We'll hang them over top of the pond and feed the fish. So hopefully that'll help the fish get better in there. And then Jaden's like, well, I want to go fishing. So we're going to head into town because we're going to stay up here another day. I got to go to the doctor's in the morning. Well, I got to call the doctor's in the morning and go in the afternoon. I got to get my leg checked out. I did something at work. I kneeled on something or got up wrong. And now I got bruising on the side of my leg. So hopefully we get good news on that. So we're going to stay up here. I'm just going to keep my leg elevated and not walk as much. So I'm going to bring Jaden down to the lake that my grandpa told me about down the road. See what kind of fish are in there. I haven't fished it ever. He did, but I think he said he got a couple catfish or bass or something out there. So we'll see what's in there. Maybe I'll clear it up this afternoon. We'll go back out. Maybe check to see where they roost. Yeah. I know the population of turkeys is good up here. We've seen them. Well, you guys seen them in the previous videos. So yeah, we're going to head into town and stay tuned. Hi, welcome back everyone. We just got back from town. We went and did some fishing. Got like 5 good size pumpkin seeds. So that lake's doing really good. So we got the boat up here and the trolling motor, but it started downpouring on us, so couldn't get no video of that. So with that lake being the way it is already, we want to definitely get that boat out with the trolling motor and stuff. So I think that was it. I don't know. I'm confounded with all the rain that we're getting today. It's unreal. I figured it was just gonna sprinkle and we just pop the tent up and hung out of the tent. No, it's really coming down. So I'm gonna have to look at those corn feeders that we have and see what the motor's working on still. They've been sitting, I'd say at least 15 years maybe. We had no baiting in Michigan for a long time. Couldn't tell you when it started. So these are the feeders that we had sitting around in the back. I thought I had, well, I do have one. I don't know where I just put it. I'm probably put it in the back shop. I looked at this one. This one looks like it'll work. I just gotta get a battery for it. So we're gonna come back up next weekend. Or end of this week, and see if John can get on a turkey. And then I'm up for a turkey, and then Jaden's gonna hopefully fill his tag. So we got all of this week, but like I said, I got a doctor's appointment. So we got this one. It's day and night, like dusk, dawn. It's not on a timer. So they'll get fed early in the morning and then just, I think it was set up for like half hour before dark. So we'll see how that works. And then that one spins once it goes off, where this one is a one directional, which is also dusk and then dawn. Yeah, I figure we have no use for these anymore right now since there's no baiting. And then so this one is also not on a timer, but I do have one mechanism or motor that has a timer, I believe. I don't know, it had a device on it, so I'm thinking if you could set the time when you want it to go off or whatever. So at least we're gonna put one of these on each end of the pond, and then I'm gonna look for another can or something, like a barrel or bucket or something, and I'll put that other one on there, and I'll put that one in the middle. But eventually we'll have a dock built out there. And then I'll probably end up putting this one on the dock because it's directional. Or one directional, they don't spin, so the bait or the food won't land on the dock. It'll just shoot right out in the water. And then the kids and everybody, friends that come up, they can watch the fish come and feed or whatever. So that'd be cool. So I'll have this one mounted on the dock, but right now we're just gonna see what trees are overhanging the pond, and we'll just hang them from the pond, and if we have to take the boat out there to fill them up, we'll do that too, or we'll lower them down and tie a rope on something and pull them back into the shore. So, a lot of options, but right now, none of them have batteries. I did find two of my old batteries I'm going to bring home because I didn't bring the charger up. I'm going to get these charged, which this one I did not know that it was a charging battery because it's just standard. I've always seen these and think, oh, they're one-time use. It says, do not charge in sealed container. And avoid total discharge and always charge in a well-ventilated area. So I'm like, oh, it's rechargeable. I'm glad I didn't throw this away. Which I bought it actually for, I think this can right here, when we had baiting and never got put in there. Oh, that's right. The bear took my can down. That's what it was. It's chilly. So, I got these mounted up, ready. So next time we come up, which will be in a couple days, we'll get these hung from the tree and filled up. I already got the food. We just gotta fill these up, put batteries in them, and let it go. So, it's one project almost complete. And then, anything else? That's probably all the projects I'll probably be working on this weekend, just with the miserable weather we have. I like to get the sprayer out and the seed spreader out and get them working and calibrated and stuff for the food plots that we're going to be doing in 4 weeks, and we'll be back on the food plots. Can't wait until that's done. I love doing the food plots. That's why I do them. It's not just to keep the deer out, or keep the deer on the property, of course, but, just cool being out on the quad and seeing what I can grow. Well, good morning, everybody. We went out this morning, got a earlier this morning, around, I think we got up at 4:30, got out in the woods, well, not really the woods, we just walked out back about 5:30 to see if there's any gobbling, and we stood out there for an hour waiting, no gobbles, so we walked all the way back to the beaver dam. And still no goblins, so we came back, got some breakfast, and I gotta get ready to go to my appointment today. So, no turkeys this weekend. We're going to get things packed up and go to my appointment and then see what they say, and then I'll be at work tonight. Work 4 nights this week, and then we'll be back up with everybody. It'll be me, John, Jaden, John, and I. We'll all be up here hunting this weekend. or end of this week. Yeah, I got two nights. I'm used to deer season, going to work for four and then coming up for the weekend, but I only got a week to hunt, so we're going to go back. I'm going to work two nights, and then we'll be back up. And we'll be back then. Probably for the weekend. Get some stuff done. And I believe next weekend is my cousin's hunt. Grandpa's coming up for that. And then we have a week off. And then we'll be back up here doing the food plot, so. Yeah, so we got a lot of thinking and figuring out what we're gonna do for the rest of the week. I have Jaden go to one field and I'll go to another field and see if the turkeys are circling me or going to him or vice versa. 4:30 in the morning came too early. So we're gonna hurry up and get back up. We're heading home. I'm going to my appointment to get some sleep for tonight. We're going to end the video here.